So I've already downloaded the software. I'm going to go ahead and extract it with 7-zip, an awesome tool, if I may say so myself. It's open source, it's free, and I use it extensively. We have inside here three different directories. Server, which is the single sign-on server, the core of the product, does all the login, the authentication, everything. It manages everything. And then we got the single sign-on client, which is middleware between the web application, your web application, and the single sign-on server. So it's nice middleware. It handles all the session logic and everything that's necessary there. And then we have a third directory called native app, which contains Android, iOS, Windows Phone, as well as desktop operating system, Windows, Mac, and Linux code samples that are the basis of integrating a native application with a single sign-on server. I'm not covering that today. I'm going to focus entirely on installing the single sign-on server and the single sign-on client and getting them to work with each other. And yes, you just saw that it is 7 megabytes. So it is a very large product. So let's just get started. We see install.php in here. I'm going to switch over to my browser. I am running a web server, Apache, on my local box with PHP. It's all set up. It's ready to go. And as you can tell, I've already got a URL there, which means I've done this video so many times and failed to produce it so many times that I had to pre-plug it in. Apparently, I can't type. So we're going to skip the first couple screens. They're just basic information. And then we hit the compatibility checklist. This is very important. Every last one of these needs to be green yeses on a production environment. Since I'm on my local box running a local web server, installing over SSL isn't as important, but on a public server, it's got to be there. All of these need to be green yeses. Moving on. The next screen is setting up the database. On a production environment, you're going to have MariaDB or MySQL or PostgreSQL as options. Since I'm on my local box, I get a third option, SQLite, which I'm going to use because it makes it way easier to do a demo. I'm going to go ahead and just test the database settings, and SQLite works great. So I'm going to go ahead and go next. All right, here is where you set up how the single sign-on server does email. So I'm gonna go ahead and just plug in some quick information here. All right. Now I am running a very interesting little tool, which I think is awesome as well for doing some quick localhost email testing. So there, I was able to send a SMTP message to myself. You can see my previous attempt where I failed previously. It's a tool called Papercut. It's free. It's for Windows and I think anything that supports .NET, but I don't know for certain. Don't quote me on that. Anyway, I can see that my test email came through, so I'm going to go ahead and continue to the next page. On this page, I'm going to disable the security through obscurity features to make the demo easier. In a production environment, you want these set to yes so that it secures the endpoint, as well as the administrative interface a little bit more. But security through obscurity, as anybody will tell you, is not actual security. But it does make it harder to guess. I'm also going to use less safe storage. It's a toss-up which way to go, really. This allows me to edit settings later manually. I happen to like it to say yes, but it does reduce the security just a teensy little bit. I think it's a fair trade-off between ease of use and security. So I'm going to go ahead and install the single sign-on server right here. Just click that and bam, now I've got it installed. But if I click this, I'm going to get an invalid user token, which means I've got to do some additional work to make this work properly. The instructions over in the documentation do cover this. I'm going to just do it really fast to try to make this video a little bit shorter here. So I'm going to go ahead and create a file called admin_hook.php in the same directory as admin.php. And I'm going to go ahead and edit this. Yeah, sure. Why not? Okay. And I already have a hook file. And basically, you have to have this or it will give you an invalid user token. All I'm doing here is opening it up to say, allow me to access the interface. So I'm gonna go ahead and save that. So I'm gonna go ahead and go back over to my browser, hit reload, and now I'm in the interface. Now I have successfully installed the single sign-on server. It's got a database, it's got all the tables, it's got all the files it needs to operate. Everything here is functional. However, it doesn't actually do anything yet.